Hello guys, welcome to another video. Welcome to WebSense Pro. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can add stylish navigation and header on your Elementor website. If you are a developer or you are building your own website using Elementor, then you need to watch this tutorial, because after following this tutorial, you will be able to build a stylish header which will look like this. And if you are interested, if you want to make your header stylish looking like this, make sure to watch the complete video and don't forget to subscribe the channel. There's a red color button. When you press it, there'll be some magic happening and you gotta see the magic. So without further ado, let's get into the screen.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your co-host Nidashik with another tutorial on Elementor. Today, I'll show you how to design Elementor full width navigation menu with images on hover and make a WordPress hamburger pop-up menu animation. So, I won't be wasting any time and I'll be telling you step by step how you can make this hamburger pop-up menu animation with full width navigation menu. Okay, so first of all, what I'll do is I'll choose templates from the left side and go to theme builder here. Okay, so from here, we'll be choosing the header from the left side. Okay, now the header is inserted. What I'll do is I'll click the settings from the left side and change its name first. Okay, looks cool. Now we'll do some settings. First of all, I'll be choosing this plus sign here and I'll be choosing this flexbox container, the two column structure. Okay, one for the logo and one for the icon. Okay, first of all, from the left side, what I'll do is I'll choose an image widget. And I'll be adding a logo here first. Let's quickly add it. Okay, so now from here, we'll be choosing the container here and we'll be doing some settings. We'll choose px first and then let's make it 90 pixel and or we can increase it to 150. Okay, so now in the right side of the column, what I'll be doing is from the left side, I'll be choosing an icon first. Icon and drag it here like this. Okay, we'll be choosing a bar icon from the left side. Let's click it and the bars look perfect. Okay, we'll be doing some styling here. First we'll change its color to fully black. Okay, and then we'll align it to right and then we'll be choosing the main container here. Okay, scroll down here and your space between. Yeah, this looks perfect. Choose the icon here and we'll reduce its size. This looks perfect now. Okay, so this is done. Okay, so now I'll be making the full width navigation menu section. First of all, again, we'll be choosing two column structure here. First, change its content width to full width. Okay, then we'll be making it to VH first, the min height. And let's make it 100. Okay, now we have some padding here as well. So we'll go to advanced and remove the padding here. Okay, so now I'll be giving it some background color first. So let's give it a dark background color. Make it fully black. Okay, so now I want to place this section onto this and hide the header here. So first of all, what I'll do is I'll choose the container here, go to left side, go to advanced here and first change its position to fixed and then we'll be changing its Z index to 100 from the left side. So now you guys can see that the header section is not visible. So now here we want to add the icon list widget. So first of all, we'll be choosing the icon list from the left side. Okay, let's drag it here on the screen and let's list the items first. Okay. And we don't want the icon, so we'll simply delete it. Okay, now I'll duplicate it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We want 6 items here. Remove the rest and I'll name it. Now I have named all the icons here. What I'll do is, first of all, I'll change its color. Let's go to text here and let's change its color to fully white. Okay, or you can choose any other color you want. Okay, let's choose the typography. Okay, I love Poppins, so I'll be choosing Poppins here. Okay, and we'll increase its size. Let's make it 25 here. Okay, this looks good. Now we'll be choosing the container. Okay, and align items to the center here. Okay, this looks perfect. Okay, so here we'll be choosing the icon list and we can increase the space between the widget. Okay, we'll be making it 8. And the next thing which we can do is we can change the text here, the typography again, and we'll change its weight to 600. Okay, make it 600. In this container, we'll be adding an image, and for that image, we need to add a spacer widget so that we can add a background image. Okay, so let's drag a spacer widget here. Now we'll change its height to 100 VH, which is same as the parent container, so that the spacer fits here like this. Okay, we'll be giving a background image here. Okay, go to advanced, scroll down, and here you can see background. Choose that background type classic and we can insert the image. The image is inserted. Now we'll scroll down and change its position to center first, and display size to cover. Okay, so now we'll also choose this parent container here and go to advanced. Change its padding to 0 so that it fits to the screen completely. Now we need to duplicate the spacer here, but before that, what I'll do is I'll scroll down here. Go to layouts, scroll down, and I'll change its position to absolute so that we can see all the images here. Okay, now this is done. We'll just duplicate this spacer here. And for the second one, we'll just change the image here. Let's scroll down again. Go to background. Change the image here. For different images, we can also set different colors. So for the second one, what I'll do is I'll change its color to fully red here. Okay, and again, what I'll do is I'll duplicate the spacer here. Add the image for the third spacer here. We'll go to advanced, we'll scroll down again, and from the left side, we'll be choosing the background here. Let's choose a separate different image now, and let's also give it a different color. Okay, this time we'll go for some bluish one. Okay, this looks good. Again, we will duplicate the spacer here. And we'll do this thing for 6 times as we have 6 icon list. Make 6 spacers like this. Now, I also want to add a close button here. All the spacers are done. If you have more icon list items, you need to add more spacer here. Now, we need close icon here. So, for that purpose, I'll be adding a container here. Let's add a container first. Okay. What we need to do is we need to place this container to the end here, so we'll be doing that. Okay, now we'll be doing some settings here. We'll change its content width to full width first, and then we'll change it to px and make it 45 here, and px min height and make it 45 here. Okay, we'll go to advanced here now, scroll down, and first we'll change its position to absolute. Okay, and we'll change its horizontal orientation to right and make it 35 here, and offset to 35. Okay, This looks good. Now we'll be giving it some color. We'll go to style here. Change the background type and we'll give it to fully white color. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll change the border radius as well. Okay, we'll go to style, click border here and make it fully 100 from all the sides. Okay, so this is perfect. Now we'll be adding an icon here. Let's choose an icon widget and drag it here on the screen. Okay, so we have placed the icon here. Let's choose some line icon this time. The grip lines. Okay, this looks good. Let's do the settings now. We'll change the primary color to fully black. We'll change its size so that it fits here like this. Okay, this looks perfect. Okay, now first of all, I'll be adding some classes to the hamburger, the open and the close menu, the hamburger menu and this menu here. So let's go to this container here, which is somewhere here. So we'll go to advanced and we'll type the CSS class here. And for the closed one, we'll choose this container here. This container in which we have added the icon. We'll go to advanced here. Scroll down more and here CSS classes. We need to add /menu/close here. And now we'll be going to this topmost menu of this full container here. Let me show you guys this container here and also add a class here. So we'll go to advanced again, scroll down. Go to layout, scroll down from the left side, scroll more. Here in CSS class, we need to add this class here, mtw/image/. Okay, and from here, we'll also add some custom CSS code. Okay, so we'll go to custom CSS from the left side and we'll place this code. Don't worry about the code snippet. I'll be mentioning all the codes in the description below so that you guys can copy paste it. You can see now the full width menu is not visible. Okay, now here we'll also be adding some JavaScript code, that is the custom code. Okay, for that we'll open dashboard here. Go to Elementor here. Here you can see custom code. We need to click that first and add new code here. Okay, so here we'll also mention a JavaScript, a custom code here. I'll name it as nav menu. And here I'll be placing the code here. Don't worry about the code. I'll mention all the codes in the description below so that you guys can copy paste it. Okay, we scroll up and click publish here. We'll be choosing the entire site here. So just click save and close and the code will be added here. Okay, let's go back and start work. Now when I click preview here, let's see if it's working or not. When I click this open menu, you guys can see it's working properly, but when I hover on the icon list, it's not working. So we need to add some more codes here. Now I'll be choosing the left side of the container first. So that, go to advanced here, scroll down more, and here you can see CSS classes. We'll type mdw left. And now I'll be choosing the right side of the container and I'll be giving it a CSS class as well. The right side of the container contain all the spacers and the left side, you know, it contains all the icon lists. So let's name the CSS class as mdw menu. Okay, here we'll also give a custom CSS code, which I'll also mention in the description below so that it works properly on our hover. Okay, now we want to highlight this icon list here. So we'll be choosing the icon list here and we'll be adding a code to the icon list as well so that it highlights when we hover on it. Okay, so choose the custom CSS here from the left side and place the code, which I'll also mention in the description below. So don't worry about the code snippet. Okay, I can change the icon list. Scroll down in advance here. Go to custom CSS, scroll down. Here you can change the color. I changed this color to black so that it is more visible. Okay, now I'll be showing you the final result of how my full width navigation menu is looking and if it's working properly or not. We'll click publish here. Okay, save and close. And let's click preview here. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so this is the header. Now this is the full width menu. When I hover on it, you guys can see how it is working. It works really cool. You can change the hover color if you want to, anything else, or you can change the color palette, any other color you want. And the close, it's working absolutely fine. What else I can do is I can give it some color as well. Let's go to style, go to background type, and let's give it a light color. Okay, so let's click update. Okay, save and close, and let's see how it looks. Okay guys, I hope you like my tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and comment below so that I can make more such videos for you. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.